I mean, it feels like, I don't know, it feels normal to me, you know, because this is exactly where I knew I would be eventually, you know, and I feel like I'm right where I need to be. So I don't think, trust me, I'm taking a moment in. I'm definitely excited. Get to headline a show right here in Vegas. That's huge for me. So with that being said, there's no added pressure, you know. I feel comfortable. I'm excited. I'm happy. Everything is going good.
Have you crossed paths with Israel at all this week? I mean, obviously he likes to talk a little bit. Have y'all made eye contact?
I seen him at the equipment room. I walked in, he was sitting there. So I told him, I was like, hey, what's up? Like, you know, like usually with me, I see my opponent, I shake his hand. It's whatever, you know, this is a sport. I don't think I've fought anybody in the UFC that I've really had bad blood against or anything. So I'm not sure how he's feeling or whatever. They came in quickly and I was like, oh, hey, let's get you back here. We didn't realize your opponent was there, this and that. And I'm like, hey, I don't care one way or another. I mean, if he got an issue, that's on him, whatever. Come Friday night, I'll punch him in his face. So I ain't tripping outside of it.
Brad, are you surprised to be betting underdog once again in this fight? It's crazy with the amount of experience you have.
Nah, definitely not. I like it, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Are you telling a lot of your friends to put some money on this fight just for the fact that you get your plus money?
To be honest with my friends, the betting side of it is something that I don't really get into as far as like, hey, you guys should do this, I should do that, you know? Yeah. Hey, but my friends are gamblers and they love the odds.
How has fatherhood changed you? Compared to last year, you had this fight last year against Elias. This year you were your dad, and how does that change your approach?
I don't think it really changed the approach, but like I said before, it was one thing, like, in every camp, regardless of how good it goes, you're going to have bad days, you're going to have off days, you're going to have hard days. You're going to come across stuff when you get home, you're just like beat, dead, tired, whatever it may be. But having my daughter, you know, it's crazy. I can take that feeling home, and I go home, the second I see her eyes, that smile, it melts me, you know what I mean? Like, I fall in love every day, and that just melts everything away. So it made camp that much better, it made camp that much easier. You know, any type of adversity that I faced or any hard day, you know, it was a great camp. But like I said, you always have those days. I get home, I'm excited, I'm driving home, I get to see her. As soon as I see her, she's happy regardless, you know, and that just melts away from me. So yeah, I mean, as far as something that changed, I would say that.
Does this feel like your prime right now, and then you've been, like you said, you've been there for a long time. It's only like 18 months old when this or something like that.
Yeah. I honestly feel like I'm better than I was last camp. I feel like I've made a lot of improvements, and I don't think you've seen the best me yet.
What does the best look like?
I don't know, we didn't see it yet. We'll get there. To be honest, you know, I came in just the love and support from everybody, and I seen Yancy Medeiros' mom out there, and told her hi, you know, and that already kicked it off, you know, just that support right there. And then seeing all these Hawaiians over here and seeing the Hawaiian flag, it's chicken skin, you know, it gave me chicken skin, and definitely motivating, it gives me more energy, I feed off that energy, and it makes the moment, you know, that much more special. And like I said, you know, like my open workout is, this is for the fans, you know, I'm just trying to give them a good time and have fun. You're showing them a little bit, but at the same time, it's all fun and helpful.
What is it about Hawaii that you see so many great clubs?
I don't know, it's just in the air, it's in our spirit, you know, I feel like it's in our blood. It's just, growing up, for me, fighting, like, I never got to compete in combat sports, or I never wrestled or boxed or kickboxed or did any of that. My experience is gained fighting on the streets, you know, in school, whatever it may be, after football games, whatever it was. That's how I gained my experience. So that fighting spirit has always been in me, and I feel like it's always been there. Like I said a lot of times, you see, you watch on TV and movies and whatnot, you know, it's always like the jocks, or, you know, like those are the popular kids and stuff. And growing up where I came from, like, yeah, I played football, I was one of the football stars on the team, whatever. But it always just felt like the kids were like the fighters, you know? Like that's the thing that everybody looked up to, and as you're younger, you thought like these guys that could scrap, oh, that's the cool guys. You know, so it's just that fighting spirit has always been there, it's always been a presence in our life. And after I graduated high school, it's something that I pursued because I loved it. And I realized that I was, yeah, I'm pretty good at this. And you know, here I am all these years later. I've made it a career, and I couldn't be happier. Hello, guys.
Been through lately?